Well, well, well. Henry Cavill is going to Comic-Con this year, while Warner Brothers DC is not. That's got to make him feel pretty darn good. Also, that he's looking so much better in the job that he definitely has, for sure, like for sure-sies. And that's, of course, Netflix's The Witcher. In fact, he looks so good in this one particular photo, the one that he shared himself on Instagram. I don't blame you, Henry. Now, when I first saw it, I thought it was an illustration, like something that Frank Frazetta would have drawn, that a famous fantasy and sci-fi artist. The chiseled features, the thick eyebrows, the now perfect hair. Be gone, cheap wig. I mean, it reminds you why he was cast to play Superman in the first place. It's the kind of look that just isn't around that much anymore. In fact, I commented on it when I was covering Injustice 2, the cutscenes, and I said, you know, the type of physicality that would actually go along with superheroes in real life, a lot of people who look like that don't go into acting. So it's hard to find an actor. Like, I mean, Warner Brothers is like, tell me about it. Why do you think we cast Robert Pattinson as our new Batman? But, you know, people with athletic builds tend to be athletes or go into the military. Not a lot of them are like, let me go see if I can make it in Hollywood. Because, you know, it's tough. You know, most people, in fact, like 99% of people who want to be actors don't make it. So that's the other thing. People with this kind of physicality usually are like, why take the risk? I'm going to go do something else that's more of a fit with me physically. But thankfully, Henry Cavill said, I'm going to try and be an actor. And he's working on it. But I saw a couple of people, I saw two reactions to this. One was, where the heck is his other sword? We're going to talk about that. I have a theory. And then also that he looks a lot like a male version of Daenerys, right? So will he also have a lot of nude scenes? Asking for a friend. But you know what? I wouldn't be surprised if he does. Because my first thought when I saw these photos overall was that even with his better hair, it still looks cheap. But then it occurred to me, you know what it also looks like? It looks like Outlander. What is this Outlander, you might ask? Well, it's a successful cable show, you know, as successful as a cable show needs to be. But what made it really particularly well known and kind of breakthrough in pop culture beyond even just its audience is that it established a reputation for being a fantasy show made from the female perspective. And it, you know, it was kind of coming up at the same time of Game of Thrones. And so while that had a very strong male gaze, you know, at least towards the beginning. And as I said before, I think that as it moved away from that, that kind of is what is responsible for fracturing the Game of Thrones audience. Why you have like a big split with how people feel about the finale. Like, I think it went back to the male gaze for the finale and, you know, a very male-centric viewpoint. And people who'd come on board as it had evolved its female characters were like, what the heck just happened? But anyway, Outlander was always very female in its viewpoint, from its casting to how it even shot its sex scenes. Again, all which, you know, made it an alternative to Game of Thrones. You know, the media in particular was like, oh, look at this Outlander show in contrast to Game of Thrones. It was a good story. Now, I wonder if Netflix is trying to do the same here, which makes sense with Henry Cavill in your lead, right? You're like, I want to make like a Harlequin a fantasy show. And Henry Cavill certainly, especially in that photo, looks like he could be on the cover of one. But it makes a little less sense when you think about the fact that most people know The Witcher as a video game. It's also a very popular series of novels, also like Game of Thrones. And apparently this show is supposed to be based on those novels. But when your fandom, like your really engaged fandom, is in the video games, I don't know why you wouldn't try to at least bring them into this, to appease them as well, right? That seems weird. Because I also think that's probably a very male audience on the video games. So to make a female-centric show would be weird to me, right? I would say probably, you know, female and LGBT. Henry Cavill has a very strong LGBT fan base for obvious reasons. Now, also, when you look at the sorceress Yennefer and the princess Ciri, the two other main characters on the show, you can see that they're very much depicted from also the female gaze. And they're not nearly as sexy in terms of their character design as Henry Cavill, right? You're like, wow, that guy's way sexier than those two women standing next to him. And, you know, it could be, you know, not to pull focus. You know, he's taking a page out of Margot Robbie's playbook. And also because, you know, the female characters are meant to be relatable to women, for women to see them as avatars, almost to kind of like disappear, you know, not see them as competition almost, right? Maybe their performances will be better, but they're not leaping off the page, off these still photos right now. I think they should have at least given him two swords all of the game. I mean, unless Henry Cavill was having a hard time learning how to wield two swords. But I mean, come on, Henry. How hard can it be? Especially considering that with the Superman trouble Cavill is having, he should be highly motivated for this to be a big hit. And also, I think because of his Superman work, he has a lot of male fans. So you want to make sure that everybody feels welcome with this show. It can be nuanced. It can be nuanced, Henry. But, you know, I don't see such nuances. I personally still think it looks a bit cheap and derivative. Like, look at these logos, right? This one looks like Hunger Games. This one looks like Game of Thrones, as well as the medallion he has around his neck. And then this one kind of like reminds me, I don't know, of Guardians of the Galaxy or Captain Marvel. It's got like that space feel to me. And for a show, quite frankly, about a monster hunter, a sorceress, and a princess with a dangerous secret, right? I don't see any of that in these photos. It looks like a Vanity Fair shoot in a cheap European location, and I'm talking about the new boring minimalist Vanity Fair that hasn't been the same since Graydon Carter left as editor. I'm still subscribed though, because it's cheap and their articles are still very good. But visually, the magazine is not anywhere near what it used to be. And I think these photos could have been better, except for that one of Henry Cavill. That's gorgeous. Put it everywhere you possibly can. That should have been the poster, by the way, instead of just his back with one frickin' sword on it. I'd be like, who's gonna care about his swords when you look at that face and hair? All right, so anyway, as I said, maybe the actresses Freya Allen and Anya Shalorota will do a more, you know, they'll be more engaging when we actually see their performances. But I still think right now this is all about Henry Cavill, which could backfire. We'll see how it works out for Margot Robbie in Birds of Prey. But this is looking to me like a Henry Cavill fantasy soap opera, a celebration of his hotness, which could be enough, especially like on a streaming service like Netflix. It just has to find a audience or get people interested enough to subscribe or keep their subscription to the streaming service. But I would like to warn Henry Cavill that it doesn't work for actresses when they focus simply on trying to be hot, so I would advise Cavill against doing the same. I mean, sexy helps. Henry Cavill is Superman, also Cap and Bucky, right? But that can't be all you have. And I think actually that ended up being a bit of a problem for Henry Cavill as Superman. They never gave him really anything else. They just had Lois Lane constantly sexually harassing him. Okay, so anyway, we'll find out soon enough how this show is really gonna look, because again, as I said, I think we should expect a trailer at Comic-Con. So what do you think? If you're a fan of the books, how do you feel about it? If you're a fan of the video games, how do you feel about it? And what if this went the Outlander route? How would you feel about that? If this show doesn't have sex scenes and it doesn't have VFX, it should really have both, to be honest with you. I'd be like, there's your winner. But they have to have one of those two things. So how would you feel about that? I'm very curious. All right, write your thoughts down below. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.